Welcome again, friends, for our next part of this session. We are going to deal with analysis of continuous beams. For the analysis of continuous beams, we need to study what is three-moment theorem. Okay, so this three-moment theorem was proposed by one scientist named Clapeyron. Hence, it is called Clapeyron's three-moment theorem or theorem of three moments. So, whenever there are two spans, they are connected together. These two spans constitute one continuous beam. And normal methods of analysis are not sufficient for analyzing such beams. Hence, some advanced methods need to be used. Okay. So, here in this diagram, we can see there are two spans, AB and BC, and both spans are approximately same. One is L1, another is L2. Both the spans are subjected to a UDL throughout the span, and there are three moments. One is on fixed end A, another is on fixed end C, and third is on the intermediate span B. So MA, MB and MC we need to find, and in order to find these moments we have been given one equation. Okay, I shall try to cover the derivation also in short. The basic equation for MA, MB and MC is the equation written at the bottom in blue color. MA into L1 plus 2MB times L1 plus L2 plus MC into L2, it is equal to 6 times A1 into X1 bar divided by L1 plus 6A2 into X2 bar upon L2. Now we shall try to understand what is the meaning of each and every term involved in this. Okay. So majorly the different terms involved are on right hand side of the equation. Okay. So on right hand side we can see A1, which is area of free bending moment diagram for span AB. Okay, then A2, free bending moment diagram for span BC. Then X1 is centroidal distance of free BMD on AB from support A, and X2, it is different, centroidal distance of free BMD on span BC from support C. Okay, so we have to basically separate out these two spans, AB and BC. Remove the fixity for both the spans and draw free BMD. Free BMD means whatever the external load is there on the span. For that span, you draw bending moment diagram. If it is point loads or multiple point loads, UDL, uniformly varying load, anything, for that particular load, you draw bending moment diagram for that simply supported span. So you have to do this for both the spans, L1 as well as L2. And those areas under the bending moment diagrams will be A1 and A2 respectively. And their centroidal distances from respective supports will be X1 bar and X2 bar.